Hello and welcome to my channel, Intuitive Envisions 1111. I wanted to thank all of you for subscribing to my channel, and a special welcome to the recent subscribers since the last video. This is going to be a general horoscope reading for the water sign Cancer from June 5th to June 14th. As I said, this is a general reading for the collective, so it may not resonate for everyone. So this is for twin flames and soulmates. When I refer to divine masculine or divine feminine, I am referring to energies and not a specific gender. Okay, so with that being said, let's go forward. I'm going to be using the Oracle of the Unicorns card to get a general energy reading for you guys, Cancers. And I'm going to use the Romance Angel card. At the end, I'm going to use an Oracle card called the Crystal Mandala for advice or message from Spirit. The main reading, I'll be using the Gilded Tarot and clarifying it with the Celtic Tarot. All right, so let's go forward and get what your general energy is for you, Cancer. Wow, I just got this in the last reading for the other water sign, Scorpio. Okay, so abundance. Enjoy the bounty of life. Your supply is unlimited. Blessings are coming to you. Okay, so be on the lookout for, try to make sure this isn't flaring in the light. Be on the lookout for abundance, or that is the energy that you're currently in. You're feeling happy and free. At the bottom, we have dance. And you have the moon in the background, so this new moon could be affecting it. So it says, allow your body to, move your body to music. Dance with the rhythm of life. Manifest your dreams through dance. Okay, so this is a good time to be manifesting. So you could be already doing that. You could be doing prayers, setting your intentions, focusing on yourself, healing, etc. But you're in that energy. Alright, so now let's get a message from the Romance Angel card. Okay, we have new love. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. Okay, so this could literally mean that some of you guys are interested in a new love outside of your soulmate or twin flame. Or this could also represent your soulmate or a twin flame coming back as a new person. Like you almost don't recognize them because they've changed so much. So in the bottom we have romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. Okay? Alright, so now we're going to see what your current situation, what your person is in, you or your person. This reading, when I'm speaking, he or she or you, it could be vice versa. It could be you or it could be them. And then we're going to, I guess we got the first card out before I get to the next one. And that is the Hermit. So the Hermit is about kind of being alone, like withdrawn, taking a time out. Also could represent wisdom, knowledge, enlightenment, on a spiritual path. You could be dealing with a Virgo. This could also be an older person that you're involved with, or vice versa. It could work that way. Alright, so what are their thoughts towards you? Okay, and we have the Page of Wands. So you could be dealing with the relationship where one of you is older than the other, or there's a significant age difference. Page of Wands is about news, action. You know, someone delivering news could come in quickly. It could, like I said, represent like a younger person. So the thoughts of you is to bring some type of good news. That's what's going on in their head. Now let's see how are they feeling towards you. Oops, almost lost this. Okay, and we have the Queen of Swords. Okay, so Queen of Swords is about a couple of things. Sometimes it could mean like clearly communicating or cutting off people at times, you know, using your logical mind. But she's one of the leaders of communication and logical thinking. So I feel like in their feelings, they're thinking about clearly communicating to you something, or you know, for some of you, this could be someone just feeling very cold towards you, or somebody you dealt with in the past or present, and it could be a reason why new love is here. Could be you not, or them, you or them not wanting to have anything do with one another, and could be desiring new love. Okay, so I'm going to clarify those cards though, just to see. So what are they blocking, or what's blocking or challenging them? Oops, sorry, dropped something. So we have the Eight of Swords. Eight of Swords is about, is a fear-based card, not based on reality, feeling bound or trapped. Sometimes it can be good in a passionate situation, but this is blocking or challenging. There's some fear here, or someone is feeling trapped. Okay. And then what action are they going to take? Look at that, the Lovers. Okay, so the Lovers, this should be a twin flame connection. This is, the Lovers is about a passionate, you know, love that is just unlike no other, like no one can make you feel like this particular person. And I feel like the action they're going to take is they recognize that you are their twin flame, and they want to come towards you and give you everything that you deserve passionately and everything. Yeah, that's the action you're going to take. Okay, so the bottom, the outcome card. Yep, look at that. You got the Four of Wands. Okay, Four of Wands, especially in a twin flame connection, this represents 11-11. It's also meaning about foundation. Okay, so this person is someone you already know, but it's going to feel like it's new because of they've changed in some kind of a drastic way. But we'll get more information about that in a second. I'm going to go ahead and clarify these cards. Okay, so let's see why. Also, since the Lovers card is here, you could also be dealing with a Gemini as well. Okay. So let's clarify the Hermit card for the situation. Why is this here? There, wow, that one really popped out. Okay, Three of Wands. It looks like there's a third party situation here. There's some separation, some heartbreak. You actually could currently be in this separation. heartbreak from this person. And because the Three of Swords is about separation, it's about heartbreak. And with these two here, someone is feeling alone, and or someone could also be enlightened about this situation as well. All right, so let's see, what are their thoughts towards you? Why the Page of Wands is here? Clarify the Page of Wands. And we have the King of Swords. Okay, the King of Swords is leader of communication. He's a logical thinker. He cares about truth, you know, justice, doing things, you know, right and clearly communicating that. He doesn't necessarily, he doesn't go really by his heart. So he is clearly thinking about coming forward with this news, like coming to give you some type of news, takes action, and you may not recognize this as this person is like living his truth. It may be in the past he was kind of in denial, and you have the Queen of Swords here too. So this could be about, like I said, some type of separation. You might have been involved, or you or them, in a third party situation, and that is coming to an end, or has already came to an end, some type of separation I'm feeling here. Okay, so how are they feeling towards you? We've got the Queen of Swords here. We're going to be clarifying. Okay, Five of Wands is clarifying the Queen of Swords. Okay, so someone has, you or them has some kind of harsh feelings or conflict that I feel it may not be over, whatever happened between you. Because this Five of Wands is with this Queen of Swords here is a very, you know, kind of like a harsh energy kind of together. So someone may not be over the conflict. Someone may be wanting to present this new love. Maybe they're happy without this person, or maybe you is happy without this person and you just want a new love. You're just not into it, or maybe you didn't see them as your soulmate and you're looking for your twin flame. But this Five of Wands and this Queen of Swords here and the feelings is kind of harsh. There's kind of some kind of conflict going on. All right. So what action are you or them going to take? We've got the Eight of Swords that we're clarifying. I'm sorry, not action. What's blocking or challenging them? We're clarifying the Eight of Swords. The Tower. Okay, yeah. So the Tower is about false beliefs, things that's not based on necessarily the way people think is not based on reality. So the Tower comes here to make things clear. It comes to clear out all of this stuff. So with this clarifying this Eight of Swords, I feel like this person is way too afraid, and their fears are like intensified of coming forward. They may be afraid of, you know, just the emotional side of it, but whoever this is very afraid to come forward. Their fears are like just magnified with this tower. Okay, so what action are we going to take? We've got the Knight of Wands. Okay, so the Knight of Wands is about, taking action quickly, not necessarily, thinking, just kind of coming in very quick. It also could be sometimes indicate like a change of scenery, like residence or traveling. So, but with these two cards here, even with these fears, I feel like you or this person is going to take action towards the lover here, because that's what it's clarifying. It's going to take action towards this person, but it might take them a while because they are very, very afraid to do this. Their fears are like very magnified. But this Knight of Wands is clarifying the lover, so they're going to take action. At least they're going to take it. They're going to make an attempt. You or them are going to make an attempt. And someone may not want it because you've got the Hermit and the Tower and the Lovers here. So I'm feeling like someone's fears are kind of like getting in the way of this situation. Okay, so yeah, at the bottom you have the Four of Swords. Okay, it's just kind of clarifying this. So you got two fours here, which is about foundation. And normally this Four of Swords is about retreating. So someone is feeling, what I'm getting here, is someone is kind of retreating from a relationship. Maybe they're coming towards you, or you're retreating from them and going towards someone else. But someone is retreating from a relationship. There's a separation. And someone is wanting to be alone, even if they know this person is their twin flame. Somebody is retreating. You or a person or someone close to you is wanting to retreat from this situation. It can sometimes also mean like thinking or dreaming or healing. They might be healing from a past relationship as well. Okay. Yeah, with these cards here, I feel like this person is just retreating for now, but because they're healing from a situation. All right, so let's get an advice or message from Spirit from the Crystal Mandala Oracle. Yeah, so the overall energy is, though, is based on romance. So, I don't know, maybe one of you are having, they're thinking about a new person, or just like I said, this, your past is returning and they're like almost you don't recognize them. But someone is going to make an offer or an attempt to, because they feel or you feel that they are your twin flame. What message do we have from Spirit, advice for Cancer? And we have number 21, Ascendant Master Lady Nada, and I don't really know how to say this, Rhodochrosite, something like that, sensitivity. Okay, Crystal Masters number 333. I'm going to read from that in a second, but I'm going to see what's at the bottom here. Archangel number 13, Archangel, I don't know how to say that, Adnachiel and Tiger's Eye. Tiger Spirit Rises, Crystal Angels, 444. Okay, so I don't know, those numbers could be significant to you, but let me go ahead and read this message from this book to see how this may tie in with your horoscope, Cancer. All right, Oops, sorry. I have a big magnifying glass there. I can't see sometimes in these lighting, weird lighting. Okay. We bring you the blessing of sensitivity. Being sensitive in this world can be tough sometimes, yet your sensitivity is essential if you are to consciously feel and work with subtle energy. Receiving and sending telepathic transmissions, feeling and releasing energetic cords, tingling with exquisite blessings of divine love, sensing the whispers of divine grace, and seeing the luminous sparkle of particles of life force dancing wildly, and the beauty of shimmering auric fields in dazzling and colorful display. To be given the gift of sensitivity to perceive the energetic world is like being invited to the most special and extraordinary exhibit of sacred art. You may have struggled with your sensitivity, found it difficult to bear during times of emotional suffering, yet you have a great gift and it will bring you so much joy. If you are learning to develop your sensitivity, we will help you so you too can feel uplifted as you witness the energetic beauty of creation. Okay, so what I'm getting from this message, from this card of sensitivity, is that you or whoever you're thinking about is highly intuitive, and they're sensing that this someone from their past is coming to offer them this relationship, and is creating this joy and this happiness feeling and this feeling of dance, because it said dance in this message here. So you may be already feeling the romantic feelings. You might already be feeling the connection. This person might have already reached out to you, or they are going to, but you are already sensing this. You are sensing this feeling, and it could be also why the Four of Swords is here, is that you may, you or them are maybe dreaming about this connection. You're kind of feeling it take place, but you're very intuitive, whoever this is resonating with. Okay, so I hope that resonated with you guys, and if it did, please like, subscribe, share, or comment below to get my latest video. Click the little bell there, and I want to thank you all very much for watching, and I appreciate you very much. Have a good day or night, whatever it is, wherever you are, and until next time, next video, peace, love, and light.